That Yangjia was able to obtain the quintessential of the Yangjia style, added to the theory of Yin and Yang and the Taiji classics, added to what he already knew as a Norman martial art. Added to that his own personal investigation. As he was investigating this form, the Yongnian Yang family compound, this Yang, the Yang family Yongnian compound had invited a teacher to their place. A man named
Ye Ji Mei.
Who was a student of Wang Yen-nien. And now we have, so he has a lot of things that are going on. He's investigating all of these things. And it was at this time that we can say that the Yang family Yin tradition of Taiji Chuan was created. At that time it wasn't called the Yin tradition, but after he created this particular style, he started to go all over the world, all over China, and would test his skills against anyone. And no one was able to defeat him. And it was this time that he received the nickname of Yang the Undefeated, or Yang Wu Di. No one was able to defeat him. And we can say he was all of China, the undefeated. But he had no particular name for the form that he was practicing that he became undefeated with. And people would ask, and they would ask him, where did you get this? Where is this coming from? And he said, would say, well, I just read John's Anakama classes, I've read Taiji theory, and so on.
So Yang Wu Di 成名以后,
and only after Yang Wu Chan obtained the honor of the nickname Yang the Undefeated, where it was now something called Taiji Chuan. Before this time, it was either there was Chang Quan, or Mian Quan, or Rou Quan, soft arts. But there was no particular style that was actually called Tai Chi Quan. And so we believe that the Taiji Chuan started with Yang Wuchan. Why is it that we call what we practice the Yin tradition of Taiji Chuan? This is another story. As he became more famous and as he had gained gained this reputation, then the people in the, at that time, the emperor's court, in
Shi,
had heard of him. And many of the great generals who tested their kung fu out against Yang Chan were not able to defeat him. And so he was introduced to be one of the teachers in the imperial court. Was a Qing dynasty.
是属于汉、蒙、回、藏、有五种部落。
There are five major ethnic, different ethnic races in China, and one, the majority are Han Chinese, but at that time the rulers of China were not Han, they were Man.
Hui.
There's the Han, the Man, the Hui.
Zang.
Zang from Tibet, Mongolia, Manchuria, and native China.
So in this little the Zhong Zhu the Sisha, Hun Zhong.
And at that time, the differences between tribes and races was great. There was a great feeling of attachment to your tribe or to your race.
我这个好东西交给你清朝,
and he didn't feel comfortable about teaching a non-Han person his great form.
可是不答应不答应不去教不行。
But the Qing dynasty, you can't say no to the emperor.
你不教不教也三个头。
If you do, your head comes off.
不必教不行。
So he had no choice but to teach to agree. But he could agree verbally, but not with his heart.
所以他只有在另边一套。
And so, in order to get through this problem, he made up another form.
就是我们现在也快出版了，108四。
Which is also perhaps this 108 style, what we know of today, which is also little by little not seen very much in the world today.
这是去经用功，他把去掉了，去了精华，把精华都去掉，变了个108四。
And here we can say that in the he eliminated the quintessential and made the form, the 108
style.
But that's what he taught at the imperial court.
所以他这个权益交出去，108四权益交出去以后，
But once he started teaching this, the 108 style,
他成名的这条权，他不敢讲。
The form that he actually became famous with, and the one that he became young and undefeated with, now had to go underground. Because if he, he would, as a main loyalist, he could not now suddenly start teaching his quintessential form to his, all of his martial art friends. Because the Qing dynasty emperor would say, now why are you doing that? Are you trying to overthrow the government? And then of course his hand would come up again.
So he
And so the form that he had created now had to be
hidden.
And even the students that he had around him that were not in the court, or anyway associated with the emperor, even those students he was not able to teach his hidden form.
所以从这个杨班后、杨少后、杨建后这个都是小108四，教108四。
And even his sons, Yangjianhou, Yangbanhou, continued by teaching more in a more open way, even though it was within the imperial court. The 108 stuff. We probably consider that Yangjin Ho and Yangban Ho both learned the Yang family hymn tradition, but we don't know for sure.
因为不敢教，所以也不教了。And
so, because the father also didn't dare teach openly the hymn tradition, of course they too did not dare teach any of their students the hymn tradition either.
所以是都传到108.
And so they continued with teaching the 108.
这个密传最后怎么办啊？
So what would happen now to MIchuan, the hymn tradition?
不能这么就完了，说完了，没有了。
Continue like this, that would be the end.
所以他就传给他的两个小弟班子和姐夫。
He taught his sons.
传给班子以后啊，这班子你不能传人，你不可以再传人。
And even though Yang Ban Ho knew the form, the hymn tradition, he told Yang Ban Ho, don't teach it.
这叫姐夫。
And he chose Jian Ho as his official successor.
因为什么他不让班子传？因为班子的心情
Why is it
暴烈?
That he didn't want Yang Ban Ho to be the successor? Because he was, his personality was more violent?
一出事，不是打死人就是受伤。
And as soon as his fist went out, it was either the person died or they were seriously injured.
所以这个密传家你不能再往下传。So
Yang Yuchan felt that he was not the appropriate one to be the successor.
不过后来班子或者时间也不长，就过世了。And
eventually Yang Ban Ho died.
所以这是他的性质的关系，生命也很短。
His not lengthy life to his personality, his violent personality.
所以给至于给他的三子建和吧，让建和教，说只可以逆传。And
so he said to Jian Ho that this is now you are the official successor.
你只能传一个人，传一不传二，不能传两个。
The Chinese have a saying which is you can teach one but you cannot teach two.
所以建和吧。 就在他的这个学生里边，甚至于连他的自己的小孩杨成禄都没传。And
Jian Ho, over the years, was looking for a successor. As he became head of the Yang family, Yang Chan had died. He became head of the family. He was looking for a successor. But from amongst his own students, even his own son Yang Chengku, he didn't find anyone that he felt deserved the title of the next successor.
建后很了解这套密圈的全家。
Because Yang Jian Ho understood that this hidden tradition
是很不容易了解的。
Was not something that's easily understood.
所以一定要传一的话，一定要找一个奇才，这个叫奇才。
If you're going to have a successor, you need to have someone who's got unusual qualities.
他真能够去掌下来，这种人才才能传。And
be able to teach one student very well.
所以在那么多的这个杨家里的学生里面，只看中了张庆林老师。And
the one student that he found that he looked favorably upon was Zhang Qingli.
为什么看中张老师呢？Why
was it that he found Zhang Qingli favorable?
他就合乎这个奇才。
First of all, he had an unusual body structure.
第一个，身高170公分，又高又壮，170 centimeters tall. 膀宽。
But he had very wide shoulders.
肩宽。
Wide shoulders and wide shoulder blades.
手大。
Big hands.
我们这个手啊。
Our hands are about this
big. 比他张老师手上的就是小孩子的手。
And if you put your hand against his hand, it would look as if a child's hand against an adult's hand.
我和张老师练拳时候去比一下，张老师我比你的手都长。
When I was practicing with Zhang Qingling, my teacher, I said, Zhang Lao Shi, can I try and see how my hand compares to yours?
这一比下去啊，差一半。
There's about a half a hand difference in length.
宽度又差一半。
And another half. I could put my foot with my own shoes on inside his shoes. And so he was very, very stable. And once his hands got to your body, you never escape. It was as if his two hands on your body suddenly had you controlled totally. Even though he was very tall, but he was very sturdy. This is a great body to have to practice
in Taiji.
And Yang Jianhou found him to be a great student and would teach him privately in his own part of the family compound evenings at about 3 a.m.
到杨祖师的这个杨建侯's
private part of the family compound, and he taught him every day, every evening.
经过三年的苦练,
after 3 years of difficult practice,
把这条全家传给扎罗,
he was able to say that he had transmitted this form to Dante.
然后正式拜师,
and then he entered the door with Yang Jianhou.
过去五年,
in the past, in the world of martial arts,
真正传下去以后要拜师,
once you've truly been you've received the teachings from your teacher, you must enter the door and become a valid student of your teacher. This is one of the requirements that a teacher would make of its students. Of his students.
实在说起来，张老师也是一个很有缘分。
And we can also say that Zhang Qilin was fated or destined to have his teaching.
张庆林老师本来是从 12岁,
because at the age of 12,
到杨家去小学,
he entered the Yang family compound to start studying.
他这个小学是要住在老师家里,
but he wasn't the ordinary student. He was a student that actually was adopted by the family and lived there as a family member.
除了练拳以外, 还得给杨家做事,
and besides, in addition to practicing the form, he also worked in the
family compound.
And he started living in the Yang family compound at the age of
12.
In the very beginning, of course, he didn't study immediately, but directly with Yang Chenhu. At that time, Yang Chenhu was in charge of the training. And in those early days, he had not yet Baishi or become a valid student. This idea of becoming a valid student is not to be taken lightly, and it was a very serious official thing at that time. At that time, he would practice a little bit, work a little bit, practice a little bit, work a little bit, kind of work study program.
所以这个练武的人一定要住在老师家里才能练出来。
But even so, in traditional ancient China, that was the way that students were brought up through. If you had to live at your teacher's home.
所以张老师这个样子，所以是好像是，哎，他是杨成武的学生，不错，是跟杨成武老师有缘，不过没有正式拜师。
And in the beginning, he was considered Yang Chenhu's student.
真正拜师是拜这个杨家MIchuan杨建侯祖师。
But in the end, he ended up learning Yangjia, MIchuan, Taiji from Yangjian Hou and entered the door and became a Bao student of Yangjian Hou's.
So this is Chuan Yi Bu Chuan, is Yangjian Hou Jin Chuan the Zhang Bao Shi.
And this is how it came to be that the Yang family Yin tradition also went outside the family to someone who was not a Yang family with the last name of Yang.
我三年前回大陆之后,
3 years ago when I went back to China,
张老师在大陆上名望还很高,
many people had still knew of Zhang Qingming.
我每到一个地方, 大家都知道一个张清明, 张老师,
everyone knew of Zhang Qingming. They had heard of him and knew of him.
所以这就是有这个遗传 不传的全家,
and the Taiji Chuan, the Yang family tradition of Taiji Chuan, is not something that I created.
这是一个, 也是我们在台湾一个将军, 田大军,
there was a general in Taiwan called 田大军.
我那种书啊, 出书是跟他写的,
and that there was the person who, during the first edition of my book that was published, it was this Chen, Mr. Chen, who wrote the Yangjia MIchuan Yin tradition of Taiji.
Chen Dajun is Chinese general, or the Chinese old president, Jiang Zhongzheng, are from the same era.
And this particular General Qian was also responsible, one of the great warlords in China who helped to overthrow the Qing dynasty.
他是跟两个老师学，第一个是天兆林。
And he had studied with two different Taiji teachers. One was Tian Zhaolin.
第二个，他就是跟杨成武学。And
because Tian Zhaolin was Yang Chenfu's student, and because General Qian was someone with a great position, then Tian Zhaolin introduced General Qian to his own teacher, Yang Chenfu, to accept General Qian as his student as well.
所以他那时候就知道说一套不传秘传下来的一套思想，谁都不会，没有人会。不知道不传，也不传秘传的。后来在台湾遇到我以后，And
in Taiwan, General Qian and I met.
我教太极拳之后，他说：“哎，你会几套拳？”
He said, "Oh, you know this form?"
我说我是跟张老师学的。
And he said, "I know of this Zhang Qingming." And Master Wang, I said, "Well, Zhang Qingming was my teacher."
好，我来给你写，给你写杨家秘传的全家。And
because传，现在又传下来了，又给你传了。And he was very happy to know that there was that I was a student of Zhang Qingming's. That I was now teaching this particular form that was not that was no longer being transmitted, and so it was he who helped to write on my book the calligraphy that says the Yangjia hidden tradition of Taiji.
So, 既然你传我一个，我应该也传一个，是吧？
And even though I also was the only one to receive this teaching from my teacher Zhang Qingming, so it should be that I too should only teach one person.
我这么一下子都大传特传出来了。Why
is it that now I have many students and I'm not just teaching one?
因为在38年。That's
because in 1949.
这个38年之后，张老师。
Zhang Qingming said to me.
快要我离开的时候。
About the time that I was that. When the army had to leave Shanxi.
他说你是个人才。
He said to me, you are talented.
What's the similar effect?
He said, oh, I'm not talented.
他说你是个当老师的人才。
He said, you're a talented teacher.
我说我这个我已经快到将官了，我还去当老师了。
At that time, when I was studying with John Timmy, I was already a colonel in the army and was ready to be promoted. I never even considered being a teacher at Taiji.
他说你一定会教。
But John Timmy said to me, I'm sure that one day you will teach.
他说不过我给你一句话。
But I'm going to say one thing to you.
你有了机会之后啊,
if you have the opportunity,
打破原来这个穿衣不穿耳,
then you must go beyond the restriction of teaching one and not two.
就在你的身上，就是在我的身上。
And if anyone can do that, it will be you.
你有机会一定要让他穿出去。
And so, in a way, gave permission to teach this to not one, to one and not two, and to go beyond that restriction.
他说不然的话，那就失传了。
He said, otherwise, it will, this particular form will be lost to one.
后来现在我台湾、美国、欧洲都有了，哎，大陆还没有传，大陆不会。
And now it's totally lost in China. There is no one who practices this style in China.
最近大陆用年就是杨家请我回去，把这个学校给他们。The
in China, Yangjia Taiji Association has invited me to return and to teach the style in China.
我山西家乡也要请我回去，叫我把这个学校交给他们。
And I am from Shanxi province in northern China. And people in my own province have invited me too to return to start teaching.
他们那时候光知道张老师功夫好厉害，就是一个女科学家，那科学家好厉害，不知道什么样的。Many
people don't have any idea what the style looks like, but they all know Zhang Qinglin and how great his功夫was. And they knew that he had a particular style of Tai Chi that he taught.
张老师平时他也不演，不表演给人看。For
the most part, Zhang Qinglin was a quiet man, didn't have many students, and didn't go out demonstrating.
有人一定要跟他表演，他就是后来的法师一世。And
if he was really forced to have to demonstrate something, he would probably demonstrate the 81 step.
他也不能表演，他不能表演。哎，所以大家知道一条腿，不知道什么样子。
So even though people knew of what of the special Tai Chi form that Zhang Qinglin knew, but they had not very many people had actually seen it.
说我回大陆时候带了20封书，一下光光没有了，大家真的是送了。
And when I returned,
最后要的人没有了，我都给。